try to address the question, why if I have a trace of rho square equals to 1, then it's a pure state, and why if the trace value is lesser than 1, then it's a mixed state. So this formalism is very common, and this is indeed the most standard notion which distinguishes the pure and mixed state. But let's see why that works. So let's first recall that rho, a usual density matrix, is given by the following formula. It's equals to summation over I pi psi I psi I. If there is a single component, okay, that means it's a pure state. Single component means there is only one I. Okay, so this is a general description. And if it is only psi I, then it is a pure state, okay? And if there are more than one component, for example like this, where there are certainly more than one component, it's running as a sum over I, it's a mixed state. You could also say that pure states are indeed one class of mixed states. Okay. Now, we take the trace of the rho square of it. Certainly, in case of pure state, if I take rho square, then it's going to be rho, it's going to be then, sorry, there is no I here, because it's a single component on this side. This and then again rho, so this becomes this. This is rho and this is again rho. Now we know that this is an inner product which gives you a 1, and then we are left with psi psi, which is rho. So rho square equals to rho, that means trace of rho square equals to trace of rho, and we know that rho has a unit trace. That's the definition of rho, in fact, or one out of the three important properties of the density matrix, that its trace is 1. This is 1. So this is why we say if trace of rho square is 1, then it's a pure state. Let's see that in the case of mixed state then. In the case of mixed states, when I calculate rho square, then it's rho, right? So summation I pi psi I, and then another rho. But then this time, let's change the index. Okay. It doesn't matter even if you do not change the index, but just to be a bit more rigorous, let's change the index. Okay? So this is one row, this is another row. And then I could write it as a single summation over I and j. Pi, pj, because they are numbers, so I brought them together. And then I have this particular outer product, psi I, psi j. Alright. Now, this inner product becomes your canonical delta ij. And which demands your I and j to be equal if you want this entire thing to survive or not vanish. So what I do next is, I just put I equals to j, and this is the reason the summation runs over I only. The pj also becomes pi, so pi and pi becomes pi squared, and then I have psi I, everything becomes psi i. Alright, and now this thing is 1, so I think psi I and pi square psi I, right? This is the rho square. All right. So far so good. Then we take the trace of it, right? Trace of rho square. When I do the trace of rho square, I take the trace of this particular sum, summation I and I take the trace of rho square. That would be to take the trace of this summation I pi square psi i. Okay. Now we can see the trace is an operation that is done on a matrix, and this part is only matrix, this is the number. So let's take the trace and operate on the matrix direct. And this is the reason I take the trace inside. Summation I pi square trace of psi i. Alright. And then we know that when you take the trace of an outer product, it becomes an inner product. So this inner product becomes this. This bra comes to the left and this cat goes to the right. And this then becomes, since this is 1, this then becomes equal to summation pi square. Alright? Okay. That means the trace of rho mixed is finally coming to be pi square. Let's recall that in this particular representation of a general quantum state or a mixed state, we take the summation pi to be 1. That goes with the definition of this rho. And we also know that this pi is something that ranges between, pi ranges between 1 and 0. Alright. What happens if I take the square of 0.2? 0.2 is the number that lies between 0 and 1. It becomes 0.04. Likewise, you can see for all the numbers ranging between 0 and 1, their squares is smaller than the number itself. So this is the reason pi square is smaller than pi. Okay. Since pi is a number ranging between, since pi is a number ranging between 1 and 0, right? And this is the reason the summation of them, that means the summation of pi squared over I would be less than the summation of pi. Okay, and this summation of pi is equals to 1, and this is the reason the summation of pi square becomes less than 1, and hence you say, listen, nothing but the trace of rho square, trace of rho mixed square becomes less than 1. And this is why we say for mixed state we have the trace of rho square less than 1. Alright, that's all.